About some of the ways that we get addicted to adrenaline that are just in our common
Oh,
life,
yeah.
that so people can start recognizing this.
Yeah,
I would love that.
in your day-to-day life, there are some pretty popular ways that adrenaline shows up. I'd say probably number one is the conviction that you're right. That moment where you say, I'm right and you're not. And you may not
Ooh,
say
I
it out
hadn't thought
loud,
about
but
that one.
even if you're thinking it inside, that moment of, I'm right.
Yeah.
Or you give somebody the look. Those are get a little burst of adrenaline. So that I think is a very common one. I also find that for individuals, when you're afraid you're not going to do it right, you also get a hit of adrenaline because the fear is often wrapped around the experience
Wow.
of adrenaline. So I think most people spend most of the day in one cycle of adrenaline or another. It's very common. The other thing that people don't realize is how much your breath is connected to the flow of adrenaline. So when people are holding their breath or they're breathing shallowly or they're breathing faster than 12 breaths a minute, they are stimulating adrenaline. That actually stimulates the adrenaline pump. And one of the best ways that you can actually release adrenaline and move into that relaxed flow is to slow down your breathing. The moment you slow down breathing to fewer than 12 breaths a minute, you turn off the adrenaline mechanism. And that's a really important thing to know. Because most people are walking around in adrenaline fatigue. They've pushed that adrenaline button so often that they're draining their supplies, both in their whole nervous system, but also in the way the brain functions, because your brain gets nutrients before any other part of your body. And so if you're using those up, you're going to start giving yourself things like sugar and alcohol, and trying to find it in food, trying to find it in escalating the argument, because you can feel that your reserves are draining away. So a lot of our work is really about how can you use those natural resources, moving in a way that promotes ease, breathing in a way that allows you to really get your vitality in a natural way. And those are things that people can use instead of adrenaline. They're very powerful.
Love that. Adrenal failure is one of the things that is becoming quite a crisis for most of us because of how rushed we are, how overworked we are, and then all the things that are demanding our time. And on top of that, what you're saying is there's these natural things that we could be doing. Can we talk, are you able to, through natural means, through your breath and your movement, be able to replace some of these nutrients that you're talking about and maybe be able to recreate for our adrenals to be re-nourished, recreated, so to speak?
Absolutely, absolutely. So the two things that I really want to encourage folks who are on the call today to practice is finding that easy, relaxed breath, and that breath comes from your belly. Most people breathe up here. So when I ask people to take a deep breath, they, expand their chest, and that actually gives your body the signal that you're suffocating, because most of your oxygen exchange is down. I'm going to just stand up for a moment. Most of your oxygen
Sure,
exchange
go ahead.
Is down here. So if you breathe to expand here when you're breathing in, that begins to give your body the signal that you're relaxing into your nervous system, that rather than breathing up here. One of the things that we teach people to do is how to, when they're breathing in, to expand this space out to decrease this space. So the people who are watching, you can learn this here. You can also learn it on our website where we have a video. I practice throughout the day, which is letting myself breathe in a way that really expands. And if I'll just do it from the side for a moment so you can see that when you're breathing in, you want to slightly arch. And when you're breathing out, you want to slightly round. So there's this movement that comes through your body that feels delicious. And it also brings your breath down in your body. So when you get that movement going, that nice arching and rounding, that's one of the most friendly things that you can do to support your aliveness in a juicy way, but in a way that doesn't stimulate adrenaline. The other thing that occurred to me, particularly this time of year, that would be really valuable for people is to know that each of us have a preferred rhythm of moving through life. And we call that your essence pace. And this time of year especially, people get out ahead of themselves. They get rushed. They're trying to do 14 different things at once and then forget something. So they're going all kinds of different directions at the same time. And it gets people out of touch with that natural rhythm of moving that allows you to be in touch with yourself and time. So one of the ways that people can experiment with that is by walking around. The next time that you're outside, so you have some space around you, let yourself experiment with accelerating, so you're moving faster, and then decelerating, so you're moving slower. So you're moving through a range of getting faster and then getting slower. And there's a place in there, it may be a speed or it may be a range, where you kind of go, ah, oh, and you feel in touch with you and aware. So when you get out in front of yourself, you might be on purpose, but you might bang into something because you're not aware of what's going on around you. It's kind of like Subway. In New York subway, you're going and doing. Know yourself with your movement flow and to be aware. It's very, very cool. And most of us got separated from our essence pace very early on when we were kids. You probably got told to either speed up or slow down. Would you just stop fidgeting for a minute? We can't wait for you forever. So people got their essence pace messed with. But you can rediscover it. The pace that allows you to feel that you're participating in life and that you're feeling totally at home. And that's something each of us has control over. And I think that's an extremely cool thing that we can each learn.
I really love that. I'm noticing, so as you were just showing the breath, for instance, I have been breathing and it's trying to expand deeply into my belly, expanding my rib cage out. And I'm noticing that as I'm sitting here breathing that way, I'm feeling as if like my sternum is being stretched or expanded. And I'd love for you to talk a little bit about how does the body do this different type of breathing?
Yes, boy, I've learned so much about breathing from being with Gay. And I also want to let you all know that if I can learn to do it, you can. Because when I first met Gay, I looked like someone had taken a belt and tightened it around my middle and then just left it there. Because my middle just basically never expanded when I was breathing. So I learned how to do that, and I know it's possible to do that because I was able to. So I know that you can. And what people don't realize is that your lungs, since your lungs sit way down here, that this is the area where you have the most blood oxygen exchange, where you can really fuel yourself. So not only do your ribs expand out, they expand down, they expand out through your back, and they also do this cool little louver move. They open up like Venetian blinds when you're breathing in and out.